Almost a year ago, I went back to Northeastern Pennsylvania to do some railfanning between Scranton and Pittston, Pennsylvania, up in Northeastern PA. This time, we're hoping to get even more action than we did last time. This time, we have a 3-day stay over Memorial Day weekend up in the beautiful Pocono Mountains. We'll be railfanning the Delaware Lackawanna, Norfolk Southern, and the Reading, Blue Mountain, and Northern Railroad, getting ready for their grand opening festivities for their new passenger excursions out of Pittston, Pennsylvania, out of the new Wilkes Barre Scranton Regional Railroad Station. We'll also be getting several catches of the railroad's North Reading Fast Freight, as well as many other York local jobs around Pittston. We'll also get a few Norfolk Southern in there as well, and the Delaware Lackawanna Alcos doing their usual work around Scranton. Scranton has always been a railroad paradise for me, and it's always nice to get up here every year. Especially the highway coming in on Interstate 380, rolling right through the cliffs of Dunmore, and then you get the view of downtown Scranton. In this video, we'll be back up in Northeastern Pennsylvania, railfanning in one of my great places to ever railfan. The journey starts in Doria, Pennsylvania on the Reading, Blue Mountain, and Northern Railroad's Lehigh Line on a beautiful Friday evening. The North Reading Fast Freight is making its way into Pittston with a whopping 7 cars and 3 EMDs in their train. The crew of YJPI-2 is getting the cut of cars ready for the outbounds of the North Reading Fast Freight. MP-15 number 1541 and GP-38-2 number 2017 rolled past the yard office at Pittston, right next to the Wilkes Barre Scranton Regional Railroad Station. new lead track for the Scranton branch that's already been here in Pittston now has a new addition. These wigwag grade crossings were restored by the Reading and Northern Railroad after serving days on the Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad back in the day. A pair of GP38-2s from the OCS train that came up here several days earlier is heading into Coxton Yard to tie down. These two GP38-2s will be used on the Pittston trains after the grand opening excursion is completed. YJPI-2 then heads back into Coxton Yard with a long cut of freight. We now get our first views of the Wilkes Barre Scranton Regional Railroad Station, located at the northern end of the Reading and Northern's main line. NRFF slowly makes their way around the curved station platform as they pull up to the yard office before heading into Coxton Yard. But on the turn trip south back to Reading, Pennsylvania, we would get to see SD 50 number 5019 in the new fast freight scheme leading the train back south with 127 cars bound for Reading. We watch as the train rolls over Main Street in downtown DuPont, Pennsylvania, before beginning the climb up the steep grades to Penobscot. Before heading back to the hotel, it was on to Norfolk Southern's Taylor Yard to watch NSK-79 tie down their power with a Dash 9 and a Jeebo. It's now Saturday, May 27th, and it's the grand opening of the Wilkes Barre Scranton Regional Railroad Station, and the first excursion train bound for Jim Thorpe, Pennsylvania. Today's train is powered by F units number 270 and 275, which were on the United Clipper train back in April. Fast Freight SD 50 number 5018 is going to be trailing third, with a 21-car streamlined passenger train heading through the Pocono Mountains. After making a station stop for more passengers at the Penobscot Yard facility, the F units leave the excursion southbound as they roll through the signals at Crestwood, heading for Whitehaven and Jim Thorpe. We then headed straight back to Scranton up the Norfolk Southern Sunbury line to watch Delaware Lackawanna train DL3 with a pair of Alcos reversing into Taylor Yard at milepost 672. We then head over to Ridge Road to catch the Steamtown excursion, heading for Gouldsboro with Lackawanna F3 number 664. Soon making its way south into the Scranton area was Norfolk Southern Mixed Freight 11Z, running from Binghamton, New York, bound for Roanoke, Virginia, with three locomotives and one in the middle, and a marked commuter car on the rear. We caught the train as it rolled past the defect detector at Main Street in Moosh, Pennsylvania.
Thank you.
We then headed into the impressive Neong Gorge to watch the Steamtown excursion returning from Gouldsboro, with nickel plate GP9 number 514 pulling the train out of Neong Tunnel.
And it's like, who can I go with?
Our final catch of the day would be back in Pittston on the Reading and Northern, catching the return trip of the grand opening excursion with the F units, leading the train into Pittston Station. Our final day of the trip began in earnest on this early morning in Pittston, right along the shore of the Susquehanna River and Coxton Road, where train PIME is getting ready for the journey north to Tunkhannock, Pennsylvania, with 4 engines per power today. The power at the front is PIME, while the power on the rear is YJPI2, which will be switching out cars for NRFF later in the day. Today's journey will take the train up the Susquehanna River to Tunkhannock, PA to a transload facility. They'll have cars to return, but they're not heading to Procter & Gamble in Mahoopney, so they'll be heading right back south to Pittston once they're finished with work. We watch as PIME, or Pine for short, rolls by an abandoned factory on the former Lehigh Valley main line through the small village of Ransom, Pennsylvania, along the Susquehanna River. As we were driving back towards Pittston, we saw YJPI departing, so we headed straight to Taylor Yard to watch them pull in. They have cars to exchange with Norfolk Southern, and they'll be taking these cars back with them to Pittston on the return trip. With a new cut of cars from Norfolk Southern, YJPI-1 makes the return trip back on the former Delaware Lackawanna and Western Scranton branch as they head back to Pittston. Get another shot of YJPI as they roll around the curve at Old Forge. By the time we got back to Pittston, YJPI already beat us there, but we found another train making its way out of Pittston, this being Andy Muller's OCS train bound for Jim Thorpe. The F units of course ran the day earlier, but now they're pulling an OCS train running 20 minutes behind the excursion train bound for Jim Thorpe.
see it.
We overlook a graveyard off of Phoenix Street in Doria, Pennsylvania, as the F units roll over the grade crossing at Phoenix Street, with a spectacular view of where the Lackawanna River meets the Susquehanna River with the formation of the mountains. While the OCS train headed south for Jim Thorpe, as we were driving away heading for lunch, we heard another horn. It was PISB heading for the Kaiser Valley Ranch with the same power off of YJPI-1, running light power to NS's Taylor Yard. Crew is now ready to head onto the Kaiser Valley Branch as they head through NS's Taylor Yard out to the Watt. The track is there about the travel line was originally used by the Delaware Lackawanna in Western and the New York Ontario in Western. Catch them one final time before heading for lunch, as they roll light power past us over a grade crossing. After grabbing some lunch, we head over to the Pocono Main Line, specifically the Myrtle Street grade crossing. We watch as Delaware Lackawanna train PO75 finishes up their return trip from Mount Pocono as they come back into Scranton, rolling under a former Delaware Lackawanna and Western Signal Bridge. The American flags along the 1960 Alco Diesels represent Memorial Day, which is coming up tomorrow. On the Sunbury line, PO 75 reverses into Taylor Yard, now running as DL3, they'll head in and drop their cars and get their return cars back for Scranton. DL3 returns with one car, as they head back to Bridge 60 Tower next to Steamtown National Historic Site to tie down for the weekend. Just like back in February, we're going to end this weekend back in Whitehaven, Pennsylvania on the Reading and Northern's Lehigh Line to catch two more trains. First is the second annual excursion train from Pittston to Jim Thorpe, making the return trip after their station stop in Whitehaven, as they head for Mountaintop and then to Pittston. It's only fitting we finished with the North Reading Fast Freight, with Admiral Cab SD40-2, number 3059, leading the train, with two other SD40-2s and Fast Freight SD50-5019 trailing behind a 40-car train. And once again, Northeastern Pennsylvania has been a success.